Experts are calling for the Me Too movement against sexual harassment to be included in the school curriculum. Experts warn the issue will be a major talking point among teens when they return to class this year.
Let's get today's take on this with Shelley Hutton from Nine Honey and comedian Mikey Robbins. Shelley, you get the first word on this, though. Principals are being urged not to shy away from this, and I don't know in high school how they're going to.
Yeah.
This is everything that people are going to be talking about. They want frank and open discussions. What do you think about this?
I absolutely love it. I think the thing is we need to realise it's almost a turning point in history. Mm. We will have before Me Too and after Me Too. So therefore, it is that important. And I think the best way to deal with it is to have conversations. Because I think if we educate our young men on how to behave and what is considered harassment and what women do and don't like, it's actually going to have a flow-on effect from the bottom up, which is, I think, is brilliant. I had a huge fight with my dad on Christmas Day because he thought Me Too is a bit of a witch hunt. And I'm like, Dad, you can't think like that. He's like, oh, no, women love a wolf whistle.
What?
No, they don't, Dad. No, they don't. But I said, I explained to him, he's from a certain generation.
Shelley, my mother actually told me last night, we were having this discussion, yeah. She said when she was growing up, they would walk down the street, somebody would wolf whistle, they actually enjoyed it because they took it as being a compliment.
Whereas I feel afraid. I feel offended and afraid if someone wolf whistles.
I guess a change in the generation.
Quite frankly, I see a wolf whistle as an aggressive act.
I do too.
It's aggressive.
But that's why I think if we get an education in the schools, it's just going to have a flow on, which will be easier than like me having to have another chat with my dad.
But see, here's the thing too, like when they talk about sex ed in schools, we all had sex ed, but it was mechanical.
Yes.
It was basically do this to that and this will happen and blah, blah, yep. blah.
Still is for some of us.
Well, there. Fold tab A to tab B and we're done.
And we're back.
All right.
But I think this is a really good jumping off point
yeah.
to explain things like, you know...
Emotion.
Emotion, what, you know, to respect consent, to respect, for gender respect. As I said, you know, as long as if we don't have sex ed in schools, let's just put a little bit of thought into it
yeah.
and a little bit of, you know, making our boys into the men we want them to be.
Yeah, I think if you start, especially with men as well, you've got to start young.
Let's move on now. Surf lifesavers in Victoria are frustrated by the number of beachgoers refusing to swim between the flags. They're so fed up that they're considering a hard-hitting advertising campaign to shock swimmers into doing the right thing. Now, Mikey, 18 people have drowned.
It's been a shocking summer.
Yeah, it has been.
It's incredible.
This summer. Hundreds more have been rescued. Obviously, more needs to be done, but is this the answer?
Well, it's funny. I grew up in a surf life saving house. My dad was in surf life saving and stuff. And I still get frustrated when I go to the beach and I see people not swimming in between the flags.
Yeah.
I don't think you can do on the spot fines. Maybe you could dack them. Just make them walk around. But it is, you know. We don't have enough lifesavers as it is, and on a busy beach, not only if you swim outside the flags, not only are you putting your life in danger, but you're putting someone else's life in danger because you're taking up, you know, lifesavers' busy time to haul your sorry butt out of the water.
Maybe you need a swimming license. You know, like you learn to swim, you get a license, and then you can go to the beach. Well, that's a little bit.
Growing up in Queensland, I learned to swim.
It's a little bit twilight. That little red carpet to come up there. There's a bouncer there at the Bondi Beach.
Yeah,
you can't come in here, mate. Where's your ID?
I'm with Son. Nah, I think it's so sensible. We are an island. Everyone seems to forget that. We are surrounded by beaches.
I don't know.
I learned to swim before I walked.
We are girt by beaches.
We are girt by
beaches.
We're
chock full of girt.
Up to here with girt.
But I actually do feel a bit frustrated for the lifesavers. They have to focus between the flags. And if they're now having to look outside of the flags, it's actually going to put other people's lives at risk. So I think fining is a good idea. It will be hard because they'll have to have their ID and stuff like that. But even if it was only for a short term to shock everyone into paying attention, maybe it's an answer.
Those fines could raise money for surf lifesavers.
Great.
Yeah. Could be a good thing.
Yeah, that's true.
All right, let us know what you think about these because Shelley and Mike are going to stay with us when we come back. Science, Sonia.
Science.
Now, Queensland is known as the Sunshine State and the Tourism Board is out to prove it. It has asked the Bureau of Meteorology to forecast with a sunnier disposition when informing the public about the day's weather outlook. Now, apparently, current forecast language, such as partly cloudy and a chance of rain, should be changed to mostly sunny.
and likely sunshine.
A delightful sprinkle.
There you go. A cooling shower.
A cooling shower. What's that? Water down the back of your neck? Lovely. Shelley and Mikey are back for today's take on this. Shelley, they've requested rain be, as Sonny said, cooling down showers for your rain, because it's hot up in Queensland.
I am a Queenslander and I think this is ridiculous. I mean, come on. You want to know whether or not you've got to take an umbrella.
You are.
And so, therefore, you want to be warned.
But was your glass half full?
No.
Hang on, but which part of the cooling showers, the showers bit, did you not hear? Showers, umbrella.
Yeah.
I love that. Queensland, perfect one day, lying the next.
Are you calling Queensland fake news?
Fake news.
We will know that they are really BSing us when they start referring to hail as happy, happy sky ice. happy sky ice.
I love it.
Get your glasses out. Get your eyes in my drink.
Cocktail hour, everybody.
Instead of cyclone,
it's slushy hour.
Instead of cyclone, it's extreme windsurfing, Max.
Well, look, let us know what you think about this. I'm quite on board with it. I like it.
I like it.
Hey, what age, though, do you become an adult? Don't ask us. There's four of us here who are still kids. But according to scientists, it's not until you're 24. This research is from the Royal Children's Hospital that say because young people are now staying in education longer, they're delaying milestones like marriage and parenthood. So that means I didn't turn into an adult till I was 33, Mikey.
Yes,
but you're 17, you get a driver's license, you can vote at 18. What age do you reckon it is?
Still waiting for it to kick in, mate. Yeah. 54? I do understand. Like, I look at my parents' generation. By the time my parents were 23, they had two kids.
Yeah. I reckon when you have your first kid, maybe.
They had jobs. I think they put a deposit down on a house.
Oh, you put a house down, yeah.
And when I was their age, I was roaming through the jungle naked. Well, not really, but, you know.
Oh, so eye-opening experience, you know.
Actually, we don't tell all in the forest. But, you know, I look at the responsibilities my parents' generation had, and I didn't start thinking about those things till I was definitely in my 30s.
Oh, absolutely, yeah.
I think they need to man up. I mean, seriously, we are putting cotton wool around these kids already. So now, if we're going to say, well, you're not even really an adult until 24, that gives them another couple of years to be irresponsible.
What do you mean irresponsible? Don't you just want to have fun, Shelley? Look,
but
you
can be
fun. You're
responsible
still having fun
as an adult.
We're all still having fun.
You said a fart joke in the ad break, okay? We're not going to talk about being adult on this
and
show.
It was really good, too.
The joke, that was.
Not that.
Because that...
See how mature we are right now, ladies and gentlemen.
I do get your point, though, because if you say 24...
Then you don't have to be responsible.
It's almost a licence, like, to just...
Oh, it's like a line in the sand. People go,
not get a job.
Not even
an
adult.
I was talking to my 15-year-old niece about getting a part-time job, because when I was 14, I went and got a job.
Yeah, sure.
I don't know if you guys did. Yeah. Everybody did.
I was at Woolies.
Yeah.
Woolies.
Coles. We got it covered. Aldi wasn't around then, but, you know.
I was at Mitre 10 or some hardware store. Yeah.
So manly.
I'm allowed to be manly in my teeth.
I mean, because you said it like this, I was at Mitre 10.
Seriously, is that where you got your love of cabaret?
I can see him with a tool belt.
I've been caught in a tool before.
I love this idea. Aisle 3, hammers, nails and show tunes. Hi, baby.
Mitre 10, the musical.
Chips Cross was great. Anyway, hi, Adelaide.
Oh,
what are we talking about?
I got bullied at the end of it. Grow up, everybody.
Grow up.
Faster.
Grow up.
Back in our day, we grew up faster. That's all we wanted to say.
Let us know what you think about that at home. Thank you, Shelley.
Thanks, guys.
Thank you, Mikey.
Coming up, eating to live longer. Still to-